Great pleasure to welcome you all to the House of Lords, particularly those delegates who are attending JITOpreneurs 2018 from overseas, not just from across India. And I know there are, you know, it's not just Mumbai or Delhi. I think, you know, we've got a huge contingent from Chennai as well. But as far away as Australia, Hong Kong, Thailand, Nepal, Oman, Dubai, Kenya, as well as friends from Europe and the UK. And I was delighted to participate in the hugely successful Jain International Trade Organization event last October. So I am really pleased to welcome you back again and to host this reception in Parliament at the request of my good friend Mehul Sangrajkar. You picked a very important day to be here. It's Budget Day, when the Chancellor of the Exchequer announces his spending and taxation plans for the coming year, which he in fact is delivering right as I speak in the House of Commons. So the focus of parliamentarians today is very much on our economic prospects and how to support wealth creation. And we all recognize the tremendous economic success and entrepreneurial prowess of the global Jain community. And we welcome your interest in investing in the UK, your reputation as savvy businessmen and women precedes itself. And I won't pretend at this moment that the UK doesn't face some important challenges, particularly in navigating the dilemmas of Brexit. But as business people, you know, and I certainly know as someone who shares the same background, that the best opportunities often emerge when there is a degree of uncertainty and even dislocation. In fact, it's fair to say that the whole world is going through a period of heightened uncertainty and unprecedented change with profound economic and social implications. I think you had a session with KPMG on that just earlier. And I don't just mean the geopolitical issues that we agonize over, like Brexit or trade wars or Trump, or the protracted conflicts in the Middle East and the associated migration flows and terrorist threats. I also refer to the period of rapid technological change that we are currently living through, be it artificial intelligence or autonomous vehicles or quantum commuting or gene-based personalized medicine. No sector of the economy is immune from the disruptive forces of the fourth industrial revolution. In fact, I understand you had very powerful sessions this morning on healthcare and innovation, so you've been hearing about this yourselves. And socially, we face the demographic challenges of an aging population, especially here in the Western world, requiring a radical rethink about the traditional patterns of education, work, and retirement, and also health and social care. So it's evident that we are living through times of huge change and consequence. So in this context, negotiating the UK's departure from the European Union has challenged the British establishment like no other issue since World War II. And in the coming weeks and months, it will be a crucial test of whether or not we can hold our nerve. But I would not underestimate the resilience of the British people. My sense is that they recognize the inevitability of change, much as you do in the businesses that you run, and they are ready to embrace new opportunities. And we should remember that this island nation, with less than 1% of the world's population, is still the fifth largest economy in the world, home to four of the top 10 universities around the world, boasts more Nobel laureates than any country outside the United States. The UK sits at the top table in global affairs as a permanent member of the UN Security Council. London remains the world's number one financial center, with more US dollars exchanged here than in New York. And the English language is the global language of choice for business. And Britain has given the world everything from Shakespeare to the Beatles to J.K. Rowling and even the chief design officer of Apple, Sir Jonathan Ive. Investors often make the most money by taking counterintuitive bets. So it would be a brave person to write off the prospects of the UK. And whatever happens, it's clear that the Jain community in this country is already making a disproportionate contribution in many walks of life, as is the wider British Indian community. So I'm confident that the 1.5 million people of Indian origin living here will not just survive, but thrive in this country, and will be of ever greater value as we forge new trading relationships with the rest of the world beyond Europe. Indeed, we reflect the power of the global Indian diaspora of 30 million people, which will be on display to the world later this week, when on Wednesday, Prime Minister Modi unveils the Statue of Unity of the great Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, a 182-meter monument, twice the size of the Statue of Liberty, built in only 5 years, and a powerful symbol of new India on the world stage. Whoa. So, in concluding, I wish you much success for the remainder of JITOpreneurs 2018, and I hope you will go away not only grateful for the opportunity to catch up with old friends and the opportunity to make new connections, but also energized and enthused, full of new ideas and inspiration about how to make money and harness all the exciting trends and technologies which are shaping today's world. Thank you again for joining us this afternoon, and we will now have the opportunity to hear from some of my other distinguished parliamentarians.